All right, our producers are so in love with him. Here is a great introduction. He's acted in everything that matters, from American Horror Story to Descendants 3 to Watchmen. Now, new Netflix show, Julie and the Phantoms. Here comes Cheyenne Jackson. Cheyenne, good morning to you.
Good morning, Sam. How are you?
Really, really good. Thanks for sticking around for us. Tell me about this, because the log line is a little out there. It's about a band, but more than a band.
Yeah, it is. It's about it's actually about a 15-year-old girl who has lost her mom. She lives with her dad, and she finds her mom's old music in the garage. And her mom loved this band, who consequently died tragically when they were very young. So she starts playing this music. The band comes to life. They are dead, but they come to life. And through the music that her mom loved, she and the music of this band, she really learns to connect with her dad. And it's just, it's really, really, really great. Really fun, grounded in reality, and has that Kenny Ortega magic dust on it.
Well, you know, when you mentioned Kenny Ortega, of course, I'm thinking of the High School Musical trilogy. I'm thinking of Descendants. The production values here look terrific. We're going to play a clip in a minute with you in a big production number. Is that just super fun? It looks fun.
It's so fun. It's the most fun. That's why I said I would do it. I did Descendants with Kenny, like you said, a couple of years ago. He just creates a sense of play on a set like I've never experienced before. And he said, hey, I have this new role on this show for Netflix. You'd be playing a 1930s magician, ghost. And you fly and you sing. And I said, say no more. I'm there.
All right. Well, you know what? I'm glad you did that, because this clip indicates not only your singing ability, but your magical qualities as well. Take a look.
Right. But here there ain't no misery, because on the other side we live like kings. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Let your body loose. Let your body loose. What you gonna do, what you gonna do? Show you a thing or two, cause you ain't seen nothing. It's good on the other side of Hollywood. Right? It's good on the other side of Hollywood. So welcome to the brotherhood, and you will be misunderstood. Life is good on the other side of Hollywood.
And when something like that is put together, that's really big. And in the second part of that number, I don't know, 20 more people joining you on stage, is it daunting to do? There's a lot involved.
There is a lot involved, but it's not daunting because it's what I was trained to do on Broadway. I've been in a lot of Broadway shows, and the hardest part about it is to do it over and over and over, because you're really giving essentially a full out performance 50 times, because you shoot that over 2 or 3 days. My inside shirt is sweating in between takes, you know, they're like blow drying it. It's a whole thing, but that's the fun of it, to kind of keep up the energy throughout the whole time.
Speaking of fun, a new Fox show called Call Me Cat, Mayim Bialik returning to series television. Jim Parsons, one of the producers. Talk to us about that.
It is an incredible script. It's based on the BBC show Miranda, and Mayim Bialik is this 39-year-old cat lover who the idea is, can you be happy and not have it all? And Mayim is so touching and wonderful in this role. I play opposite her, and then this cast is incredible. Swoozie Kurtz and Leslie Jordan, Kyla Pratt, Julian Gant, it's this Darlene Hunt's baby, and it's one of the most beautiful, funniest scripts I've read in a long time. Manages to be very funny, but has so much heart. And we start shooting that in about 2 weeks.
All right. Well, good luck to you with that. We'll tell folks that season one, Julie and the Phantoms, is on Netflix now, so you can look forward to that.